Derek Tony, VarsitySportsNetwork.com. We're here at Chesapeake High School in Anne Arundel County, where the Cougars football team is getting ready for their 2019 regular season opener. It's just 2 weeks away against Largo. In 2018, the Cougars went 9-4, reached their first state semifinal game. They lost to Ligonier out of Frederick County, but the last 4 or 5 years here at Chesapeake under Coach Rob Elliott, it has been kind of the golden era. They've been to the playoffs 3 of the last 4 years, and they're going to hope to make it 4 or 5 in 2019. And Coach, just talk about just all the work you guys have put in from that last game when you guys walked off the field against Ligonier to right now.
Yeah, we've got a very dedicated group this year. So we're, a ton of time in the weight room. Once we hit the summer session, the 7-on-7 circuit we've hit. So we put in a ton of work. Football now with the rules, you don't start August 15th anymore, and that's when things start. So, we've been months in the process of getting up to the point of getting in pads and equipment. And first scrimmages tomorrow, kind of start to see what we have and what we need to work on.
Right. Well, let's talk about the offensive side of the ball. Talk about some kids you're excited about and some new faces you think might be able to help you guys.
Okay. Offensively, again, we lost 3 very good receivers and a very good quarterback. So we're our one returning receiver is Alonzo Wilkes, who's a 6'6" wideout. Mm-hmm. Alonzo, we expect to be our number one wideout this year. Mm-hmm. Jalen Richardson got some carries last year in a split time situation. He'll be back in the backfield. And Brian Plummer, tight end. We got a good tight end, very athletic. We expect to be able to use. We got a load of fullbacks from Forrester to Sutton to Patton to Peepos, a bunch of different guys we're looking at that maybe play a little bit more power with that than big bodies we have up front.
Right. Yeah. And talk about some of those big bodies up front.
O-line, we returned one starter. That was Brenton Vogt, who started as a sophomore last year. So he returns. So he'll end up being a 3-year starter for us on varsity. And Chris Castellino will most likely end up manning the center position for us. Other spots, Walsh will take one of the tackle spots, we believe. I've got 4 or 5 guys all in the mix for playing that left side of the line.
Right. Let's talk about the defensive side of the ball.
Defense is probably, we expect to be our strong point. We turned 3 of our 4 starting defensive linemen in Sutton, Bauman, and Wagner. We got a load of linebackers. Again, that same fullback crew. We're kind of a two-way sometimes situation here. So the Paddens, the Peeposes. The one returning guy we do have is Devin Forrester. Devin will return. I think we're going to move him to the mic this year from outside and let him go there. And secondary-wise, we've got some guys that need to step up, and we've got a crew coming up from the JV that's all battling to earn starting time in the secondary.
Right. Talk a little bit about the special teams.
Special teams. So we lost the best special teams player in the history of the school, Colton Spangler. We expect to be battling as a starting punter at Maryland as a freshman. So with Colton going out, Zach Bauman is a guy that's got a big foot. We expect him to possibly handle all 3 and punt, kickoff, and field goal.
Coach, 9-4 last year, first state semifinals. You made the playoffs in 17 and 15. Never been done before. As I was joking with you earlier, this is kind of the golden age of Chesapeake football. What has changed here over these last 9 years under your helm?
I think the biggest thing is just the kids believing. When we kind of took over, the kids, the kids wouldn't wear a Chesapeake football shirt out in the community. Our first year, we went 5-5, and they just started to buy in that, hey, we can play football here. And then a little bit of success comes. Success breeds success, they say. So I think that's been a big factor, is just the kids believing that, hey, we can go out and play football with just about anybody.
Yeah. And what does it mean to you? You're a 1986 graduate of the school. You were part of the first winning team in school history, and it's been a lot of lean years in between until you came back. I mean, what does it mean to you to kind of be a part of this?
Well, I mean, this is, I think anybody that's an athlete, they always want to go back to where they started and contribute. And we came in, you know, I've got a very good assistant coaching staff. A lot of guys have been with me for the whole 9 years I've been. Well, this is our ninth year on varsity. So it's, I'm just very proud. Very proud to take a program that had struggled, that didn't have a great reputation, and we're not the best program around, but I think we're at least respectable, and people don't look at us as, hey, that's a win on the schedule. Now we got to go play football.
Yeah, and also, we're here in the Pasadena community, the other school down the road. I don't know if you guys like Michigan. That other school up north, Northeast had a great year last year. They made the playoffs, I think, for the first time. You guys had a great regular season matchup, and you guys hooked up again in the 3A East first round. I mean, just talk about, I mean, there's a lot of things going on up here off of Route 100, huh?
Yep. Northeast, Brian Ballblitz is a good friend of mine. Brian and I kind of came up through the youth ranks of coaching, which makes us a little bit different than a lot of the guys coaching. I was at the Panthers Athletic Club, and Brian been a Pasadena Charger coach for years. We never really matched up in the youth, but now that we're here, we are. I think social media has changed it. Years ago, Northeast Chesapeake, the kids really didn't know each other. Mm-hmm. Now these kids all know each other. So it's definitely a pride situation. We've split the regular season. We split the last four meetings mm-hmm. with them, and last year we ended up playing back to back. So it's a game the kids look forward to. However, it's not the game that we have to win. Now it's just another game with some bragging rights attached.
Right. Moving forward, Coach, what's going to be three keys to success for you guys in 2019?
I think it always, with us, it starts with blocking and tackling. That's your first. If you can block and tackle, then you can play football. Health and turnovers are key. We're just not a super deep program. So we can't afford some injuries at some key positions. And, like anything, you got to take care of the football. Usually that turnover battle, 9 times out of 10, decides what happens in a game.
Well, he's in season number 9 at his alma mater, Chesapeake and Arundel County. Rob Elliott, as the Cougars are getting ready for their 2019 season opener, September 6th against Largo, as the Cougars will try again to make the state playoffs. For VarsitySportsNetwork.com, I'm Derek Toney.